Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2237, Sequence and Randarray Functions. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gellenwall. This week, we've been talking about the new modern array functions. Two new ones today, Sequence and Randarray. Check this out. Equal sequence. How many rows do I want? 10. Bam, there's the number 10. The numbers 1 through 10. How many columns do I want? Give me 3 columns of that. Bam. Where do I want to start? Let's start at the number 3 and increment by 9. Bam! Rand array. Alright, so equal rand array generates, let's generate 10 rows of random numbers. Of course, between 0 and 1. Now I need 10 rows and 3 columns of random numbers. Yes, alright. Now wait, give it all the good stuff we've seen this week. Sort, sort by, filter, unique. Did they really just give us the sequence function because people can't figure out how to make the 1 go to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? And of course, if you watch this podcast, you know, hold down the control key or select the 1 in the blank cell next to it, right? Or, heck, equal this plus 1. Grab the fill handle and drag. There's plenty of ways to do that. Is that the reason they gave us the sequence function? No, that's not the reason at all. I mean, it's an example, right? And I could stop the video right here and we'd be done, but that's not why Joe McDade and the Excel team gave us this function. Why did he give us this function? Because it's going to solve all sorts of problems. Let's say you're buying a house, $495,000, pay for over 360 months, 4.25% interest rate. This is your payment right there. But hey, I want to create an amortization table with the months going down the left-hand side. I need to calculate the interest payment for each of those months. And see, that second argument right there is which period, which means that I have to take that number 1 and copy it down like that and then refer to that set of numbers over there. So in the first 5 months of that loan, my interest, total interest, is going to be $8,741. Look, this whole thing becomes really, really simple with the sequence function. So right here, instead of saying period 1, I'm going to ask for the sequence of 1 to 5, essentially, 1 to 5, like that. Bam! Oh, no, that is not what I wanted. I didn't want 5 answers. I want 1 answer. Wrap that whole thing into the sum function. Ctrl+shift+Enter. No! Look at that. Same answer I got over there. 1 formula. No need to create the sequence of numbers. It just happens. Which means that if all I want to do is calculate how much interest I'm paying in each year of the loan, so I want to go from months 1 through 12, 13 through 24, 25 through 36, I just edit that formula and ask for the sequence, 12 rows, 1 column, starting in 1 or 13 or 25 or 37, wrap that whole thing into the sum function, and it works. These new modern arrays from the Excel team are awesome. Now you need Office 365, you need that version, which if you're on the semi-annual plan will probably reach you in January of 2019. For more information, check out my book, Microsoft Excel 2019 Inside Out. Click that I in the top right hand corner. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.